So the last 12 pieces that I'd like to play for you are all actually part of the same one piece of music. So Chopin wrote a whole bunch of what he called etudes. And an etude is just another word for a study or an exercise. So you could, you know, play scales up and down all day to warm up or something, or you could play one of these. And he wrote 24, two sets of 12. There's the Opus 10 set, which came first, and then the Opus 25, which is the second set. And there's a few bonus etudes that he kind of throws in that aren't part of the two sets, but there's really 24 main ones. And these etudes, the whole set is about a half an hour long, and each one is anywhere from 2 to 4 or so minutes long. So they're very, very short in, you know, for classical music standards. But the neat thing about them is that each one of them has a nickname, either official or unofficial, that kind of describes, you know, either what the etude is exercising or what it sounds like. And it's really kind of neat. So, like, for example, the first one is nicknamed the Aeolian Harp Etude because it sounds like there's a harpist on the stage, you know, playing the harp. The top note is plucked the entire time, while the rest of it is just kind of, you know, how the harpists do the kind of a thing. And it's that. And at the end of the piece, there's this light arpeggio that kind of runs up and down. And again, it's kind of the up and down the harp. The second one doesn't have an official nickname, but I always think of it as kind of like a spinning thread. It's like a thread with a needle or something in fabric. The left hand kind of holds the beat and has also kind of a secondary melody that comes in and out. But the right hand is much more free. It's kind of this whirlwind of notes that kind of weave in and out and in and out of the fabric of the music. The third one also doesn't have an official nickname, but I always think of it as kind of like a galloping horse. It's not, you know, Gangnam style, but almost. The fourth one is the left hand etude. So it's basically the entire time the left hand is just jumping anywhere from an octave to a couple octaves very rapidly. The fifth one is known as the wrong note etude, or I used to, when I was learning it a long time ago, I always thought of it as the drunk guy etude, because it sounds like, you know, somebody is kind of stumbling around and not playing the right notes the whole time. But the middle section is suddenly very beautiful and opens up into this gorgeous melody in the left hand and then comes back to the drunk guy. The sixth etude is the etude in third, so it has these intervals of three in the right hand that kind of run up and down the keyboard, well, run up basically the keyboard, sometimes down. The seventh one is the cello etude. So I always imagine a cellist like, you know, Yo-Yo Ma or somebody on the stage, and the secondary melody is almost like a violinist. So you can really kind of imagine him, you know, digging into some of the notes, and it's a very slow, slow but emotional etude. It's very beautiful, I think. And then he moves on to number eight, which is the etude in sixth. So the sixth etude is the etude in thirds. The eighth etude is the etude in sixth. The ninth etude is the butterfly etude, so it sounds like a little butterfly. The tenth is the etude in octaves, so the octave etude in eight. So six is three, eight is six, and ten is eight. And then the last two, yeah, he didn't think it all the way through, I think. The last two, the 11th one is the winter wind etude, so it sounds like this winter storm is, you know, creating a lot of problems. And then the last one is the ocean etude, which sounds like ocean waves just crashing up and down the keyboard. I always think of it that it could have been the theme to that movie The Perfect Storm, where they're on the boat and all the storms are coming and they're screwed out there. So this is the set of Opus 25 Chopin etudes, and let's have a go at them.
Thank you.